Do you want to know the pros and cons of living in Cave Spring in 2020?
Stay tuned and we'll tell you all about them. Everybody, welcome back. I'm Hal Cohn.
And I'm Chris Cohn. We're with Cohn Realty Group.
Thanks for tuning in. And if this is your first time to our channel, please make sure that you click the subscribe button as well as the little bell icon so that you're going to be notified each and every time that we release a new video about living, working, and playing in the amazing and wonderful Roanoke Valley.
I mean, look at this background. It's just gorgeous. And if you're thinking about moving to or living within Roanoke, Salem, or Botetourt, we would love to help you. We help folks all the time that are constantly contacting us when they relocate or bring their family here too. So we would be honored to have a conversation with you. Just give us a call, send us a text, or shoot us an email.
And we will get in touch ASAP. So remember, we are in front of South County Library here in the Cave Spring area of Roanoke County. The pro is the fact that you've got access to a lot of amenities.
Yes.
And what do we mean by amenities? Well, this is a brand new, within the last few years, built library that's just amazing.
It is. Lots of programs too for all ages, and it's just, it is hopping all the time. Right now we're still filming in phase three COVID,
yes.
So it's not very busy. However, the curbside pickup has been slammed
they
with
have
patrons.
Been. Yeah, and when we're talking about things to do, it's like they have movie nights, they have game nights, they have like, I think, access for coding for kids and adults.
Right.
And they do like continuing education for adults, like for Word and Excel and those types of things. So you name it, they have all sorts of offerings here from that perspective. And then you may not see it now, but as we're walking around here today, over here is a trail. You've got access to walking trails. You've got really quick and easy access to hiking trails,
yes,
along the mountains. You've got biking, you've got fishing, you've got golf. You name it, it is available to you in the Cave Spring area. And we're trying to make sure we don't get run over here because somebody's like pushing us, but we're gonna make it through it. So we want to bring you the best value we can for the pros of this area. And they were pretty conscientious. They didn't run over us, so
no,
that's a nice thing.
There are
so nice people. That's
here.
Right. So they're looking at us like we're kind of crazy, but it's all good.
Well.
So anyway, so those are some of the amenities.
Yeah, there's so much more to think about. So there's dining options, lots of dining options.
419 West.
Mm-hmm, one of my favorites.
What's your favorite there?
Oh,
you
gosh.
On the spot? I can tell you mine. Mine is going to be the boneless chicken wings that are to die for. I don't know what they put in them or how they make them, but they are awesome.
I love their pizzas. Everything I've gotten there is good. Their pizzas, their burgers, their sandwiches, it's all good. So dining is a big plus here. There's quite a lot of restaurants. There's Rimini's for Italian. There's El Rodeo for Mexican. There's just
margaritas
a lot of,
if you're a margarita person.
There's just a lot of choices you can choose from dining wise and with, again, within a short drive. And then there's also shopping. Let's talk shopping. There's a lot of higher end boutiques here and then some just casual shopping areas for clothing, gifts, accessories. So lots of nearby shops and restaurants. We always like to encourage folks to shop local.
Yeah, and there's like three grocery stores within like a 2 mile radius of each other too, which is kind of surprising. I mean, there's two that are within 2 blocks of each other. It's kind of crazy, but those are Kroger's and there's easy access to those to be able to get your groceries and feed yourself or your family.
Right. And not only that, let's just touch on things like doctor's appointments. There's doctors, there's specialists, there's surgeons, there's chiropractors, massage therapists. So all those amenities you may need to live and have a great quality of life are nearby right here in Cave Spring.
So we're going to talk about another pro for you now. We're going to talk about the cost of living.
Mm-hmm.
And why is that important?
Well, I mean, wherever you land, you need to be able to afford it, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And most people that I talk to that are moving here are looking for a lower cost of living.
Yes.
And we can actually provide that. So, because we're about 3% lower than the national average.
That's great.
And when you talk about cost of living, there's a lot of things that are encapsulated inside of that number.
Yes.
So do you want to tell them a little bit of what those things are?
Yeah, I will try. try very hard to remember all of those.
And I'll try to fill in and interject a little bit.
Thank you. Yeah. There's utilities, transportation, healthcare, groceries, goods and services,
gas.
And housing.
Yes, housing. That's right.
I always forget that one, which is bizarre because we're realtors. Yeah. I think I just take it for granted.
Yeah. Like, you got to have a house to live in, right?
That's right.
And we're hopeful you're going to buy. We'll also help if you're going to rent. So, cost of living is 3% less than the national average. If you tune into our other videos, you'll find out more about the cost of living in general in Roanoke. And
right.
then we'll also have one here in the near future that will be cost of living more specific to Cave Spring proper.
Yeah, that'll be fun to dig into those numbers. Yeah.
So we're going to talk about Cave Spring doing a whole lot right here. Oh, does that make sense? Yeah.
No, they're doing something right.
How about correct?
Yeah, and here's why. One factor of where you want to live not only is what we just spoke about, which is cost of living. You want to make sure you can afford it, but you also want to make sure you feel safe when you live here. Their crime rate in Cave Spring is 17% lower than the national average, which is a really significant number.
Yeah, it is a significant number, and you can find out specifics for anywhere that you're going to live in the country. Go to this police databases so you can find that at the region that you're looking to move to.
Mm-hmm.
And this is just kind of generally here in Cave Spring, 70% lower. And they're doing something right, safety, but then also in general, they have a livability score of 86
wow.
out of 100.
That's phenomenal.
Which puts it way up there and ranks it as the number three city to live in the whole state of Virginia.
Wow.
So if you're looking for moving from the West Coast, from the North, from the South, and coming North, then we are a great landing spot, kind of in the middle of mm-hmm. the region on the Eastern Seaboard. So number three city in the state of Virginia is Cave Spring for livability. How
Woo-hoo.
Awesome is that? Cool. All right, so closing out the pros for Cave Spring, Virginia, we're going to talk about schools
mm-hmm.
here in Cave Spring.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of pros to living here, and we could go on and on, but this is just one thing we wanted to highlight because many of you are curious about the school system. According to niche.com, which is a great resource to learn more about the schools and where you live, they got an A+ rating. Very good.
I get to do my thumbs up and not get in trouble on that one.
And they also have a 14% higher graduation rate than the national average.
So with that, you know, a lot of people that are moving here, they're always asking us about schools.
Mm-hmm.
And we can't steer you in any way with crime or schools or any of that
right.
stuff. We can give you the statistics that we're able to find. So niche.com rates it as an A+, which, you know, if you're moving here with kids, then that's probably going to be something that's pretty darn important to you. So A+ schools in Cave Spring.
Yeah, and there are two public schools. There's Hidden Valley and Cave Spring. And then there's quite a few private schools if you're interested in going that route as well. You could check out North Cross, Faith Christian. There's Roanoke Valley Christian School. There's quite a few you can research and check out on your own.
All right, so we are still in Cave Spring.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to be hugely transparent with you and not fall down the stairs as we're talking to you today. But we love the Valley. There's lots of pros for living here, but there are some cons in different regions of the Valley, and we're going to share some of those with you starting now.
Yeah, so there's no perfect place to live. You guys know that, but it is helpful to know what you're getting into as you move or consider an area. So the first thing that may be a deterrent is that there's no real true city center
in the Cave Spring area.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there's no real downtown or popular gathering spot with kind of a mixed-use development that you see either in older developments or these newer developments have a lot of mixed use growth and everything's consolidated in one area.
Yeah, so what they have done, Roanoke County's done, is they have created a little council and some town hall meetings, and they've actually got a strategic plan in place that they're calling the 419 Town Center. And the goal of that is to make it more of a walkable area and community with some mixed-use development,
yes.
with sidewalks that they're going to add and those types of things. So long-term, that is on the horizon, that is on the agenda, but at the current moment, in the current state, you're going to drive to all these places on 419 to go eat and hang out mm-hmm. and do those things. So you've got those amenities, but they're not going to be walkable and like really that give you that city-centric type of feel. So that would be a con, but still you've got lots of amenities, lots of access to things. So we got another con here for you. Depending on who you are, where you are as far as stage of life, it may or may not be a con
That's
for you.
Right.
But this is a con that we hear from some people, and it's talking about the fact that Cave Spring in and of itself in Roanoke County is slow to grow.
That rhymes.
Yeah.
Slow to grow. So again, that may not be a con for many people. Maybe you don't want a lot of fast-paced growth, and that's okay. Then yeah. This may be an area for you. But there hasn't been much growth recently, but just know that there is a plan in place to address that and try to spur and encourage more growth and economic development.
Yeah, and one of the things they're doing in Cave Spring proper is the 419 Town Center Development mm-hmm. Plan. And if I remember correctly from reading online, it's like 2024 to 2026 is kind of the long-term planning points of it actually coming to fruition. So not too far off, because we're in 2020 right now.
Yeah, and there's a lot of information online, Roanoke County government website. Check that out, because you would be interested to find out what their growth plan is and how they want to attract some more economic development to the area.
All right, so you are looking for another con to live in Cave Spring, Virginia, and we're going to give that to you right now. So it's going to be, some people say that there's not much to do.
Oh.
But we had that conversation as we were talking through this video shoot, saying, I think it kind of depends on what you are looking to do, right?
And what stage of life you're in as well. Like, I remember when I was single and looking for nightlife and entertainment and activities, this would probably not be my first choice if I lived here. Granted, we lived in Atlanta, so it was much different. But Cave Spring may not be your top choice if you're looking for nightlife and wild action and fun entertainment.
Yeah, but if you're looking for kayaking, fishing, hiking, outdoor things to do, parks, recreation, you know, those types of things, if you're looking for the amenities of eating out and you've got conveniences, then it is going to be a great spot mm-hmm. for you. But you know, if you're single and you're looking for the hotbed of activity at night with a huge nightlife, Cave Spring is not going to be the place for you. So we're still struggling a little bit to find you some cons, but we've got another one for you. So if you're single, Cave Spring, Virginia is really honestly more of a family-centric type of area. And the statistics show that, not us saying that and trying to persuade you in any way, but that's what the stats are showing. When you're living in Cave Spring, Virginia, then you've got those stats that you're going to give us as far as why do we say that?
Yeah, so according to our research, I should preface it with, 76% of the population here in Cave Spring have already tied the knot, and 69% of the population has children under the age of 18 in their family. So you're going to find lots of family-oriented sports and recreation, entertainment, lots of that. As I recall, I mean, I grew up in Roanoke City, but I did play Roanoke County recreation ball over here at Penn Forest. I played t-ball and softball with my dad coaching many, many years of fun. But so there's a lot of that, and we talked about the amenities. Those are going to be very family oriented as well.
Yeah, and so with that, you know, you're going to want to dig into like what's the culture like as far as where you live when you move here to Roanoke. There are great areas, whether you're a family of one, whether you're a family of two, three, four, five, whatever it looks like, there are going to be spots for you. Cave Spring in and of itself, let the statistics help guide you to where you want to be in the valley.
Yeah, and just if I can add in, I mean, look at this beautiful trail we've been walking on. It's really pleasant and shaded. We've passed quite a few dog walkers and bikers and hikers, but great for the family to come out and take a short little hike and enjoy nature. So lots of these amenities tucked into the Cave Spring area.
If we want to be transparent with you, the pros and the cons of moving to the area.
Yeah.
So what we're going to talk about now is going to be housing. Where we are, where?
Housing is 5% higher here than the national average.
Yeah. And so, but still, I mean, our average price point in Cave Spring proper is about $230,000, which is not astronomical. Tax rates are low because we're like 1.09 per $100 when you're on your assessed value, which basically means if you're around $200,000, your annual taxes are going to be about $2,100, $2,200 max. I was talking to a couple yesterday touring around from Illinois, and theirs are like multiple, like $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 a year for property taxes. It's absolutely insane, they say.
I better appreciate where we live.
Yeah. So the housing itself may be higher, but you're going to save some money in other places being our region because, like we talked about, cost of living is lower in our area than the United States. So what type of housing do we have in the South County, Cave Spring area?
That's a great question. You can't really pigeonhole it into one specific type of housing style. There's really a lot of variety here. There's some older homes rooms and subdivisions and housing styles. There's quite a few ranches and split levels, but you can also find neighborhoods that are newer in construction, new subdivisions, higher in construction in these homes. So just a really a big variety of housing types and styles you can choose from. We actually looked in this area when we were house hunting and checked out quite a few things, anything from colonial to mid-century modern.
The mid-century modern ones are hard to find.
Yes.
But when they do pop up, they are really, really cool to go look at and potentially purchase.
Yeah, so lots of housing. I bet you can find something here that you would love.
Hey, and that's going to be a wrap for today. Thanks for tuning in and listening to the pros and cons of living in Cave Spring, Virginia.
That's right. We hope this was valuable for you. And check out our other videos. You'll learn more about the Roanoke Valley. Mm-hmm. And if there's anything we can do to help out, please just give us a call, send us an email, or shoot us a text. We will be available for you.
Yep. Well, you got direct access to us. You're going to have to see our contact information in the comments section. You're going to see an opportunity to do a 15-minute Zoom call with us. And then also, you can sign up for our newsletter that you'll get twice a month, so that you can get that via email, just to keep you updated about the things that are happening in the Roanoke Valley, real estate wise and just life wise.
So that's right.
Have a blessed day. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. Bye. Really just talk about the housing types and what you can expect. Purple spray if you come to Roanoke.